voice and sing it. Among the gods, oh Lord, oh, is mighty. You are glorious, glorious. Always do love. To sing this song with revelation, that is among the powers of foundation or stronghold that are around you. No matter what the enemy is doing around you, he's always there to do his wonders. If you can pick this song with revelations, number one testimony this morning will come out from your mouth. That woman said she had been swallowed by big boa for 21 years. And she behaved abnormal, and that's the spirit of madness. The enemy tormented her, but the grace of God helped her not to be on the street. But when she located the mountain, despite the forces and the demons and the power that be, the wonders of God is superior, and God gave her the victory. I want you to go deep in the spirit and sing this song with a testimony that you, who knows what is ahead of you, despite what you see, but it's a God of wonders. And let him prove he wonders in your life. You are going to sing the song again. Among. You are glorious. Fearful of. Always. The seventh time, this is the third time now. You are glorious,
glorious, glorious.
Fearful of,
careful,
always do it all.
To you, wonders, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Sing it for the fourth time. Come on, I'm on the cross, oh Lord. You are glorious,
glorious in holiness.
Fearful of,
careful,
always do.
Oh, he wonders, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Sing it for the fifth time. Among the gods,
who is lightning?
You are glorious. Sing it for the sixth time. Among, there is a deliverance going on. That's why I want you to sing it. You are Lord. Fearful Lord. Sing it from your spirit. Always do. For the last time now, come on, above the gods. Oh, yes, you are glorious, fearful of, always do. The gods is always doing wonders, fearful, holy, and praise. When Moses saw the Red Sea, he gave God this. Despite the fears of darkness, you are ahead of me. Whatever the enemy has programmed for you this week, God is ahead of them. And your testimony shall be mega. Your testimony shall be awesome. If you are that person that won the wonders this week, let me hear the amen.
Amen.
You are blessed. In Jesus' mighty name. Have your seat in the presence of the Lord. Today is somebody's day. And by the time you leave here, many will look out for you. Those who hate to see you will come back to celebrate you. Those who have spoken bad of you will be looking out to celebrate you. The wonders of God shall be seen in every area of your life. In the name of the Lord Jesus. If you are receiving a shout out, amen, loudest. Last Sunday, we talked about the topic about the power in the blood. The power in the blood. And I said to you, Leviticus chapter 7, verse 17, verse 11, that the Bible said that for the life of the flesh is in the blood. For the life of the flesh is in the blood. And he has given it unto us an atonement in the altar. In Leviticus 17, 11, we said, for the life of the flesh is in the blood. And I have given it to you upon the altar. Hear that word and take it very serious. I have given it to you upon the altar. And what is the use of it in the altar? It said to make an atonement for your soul. To make atonement for your soul. It said, for it is the blood that maketh an atonement for the soul. He repeated it again. It is the blood, meaning the blood that speak grace. The blood that bring rescue. The blood that speak vengeance. The blood that bring deliverance. For the life of the flesh. And tell me a man who has no blood, I'll tell you a man who is about crossing over. And that's why you see the issue of blood, high blood pressure, low blood pressure is so serious. Why? Because it has to do with the blood. Anything, there's an issue that has to do with blood, 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 blood. You know it is dangerous. But here, because of the evil that had been at that time and what has been on ground, Jesus came by giving us his blood. Today, somebody hear me. By the encounter of this service this week, anything that has been made as a covenant to take the blood of your family before your time and to bring you back at the back seat of life because of the power in the blood, that yoke shall be broken. You didn't hear me. I said that yoke shall be broken. And that I said to you last week that there are some battles that happen to you despite the anointing, despite your fasting, despite your prayer, sometimes even despite the grace that you are under. And you wonder, why is this or how should? Why? Because Satan is only Satan. But thank God for the authority of the blood. 2 Kings chapter 3 and verse 23 down to 27, we had a case that was mentioned to you about how three kings went out to fight the Moabites. And the Bible said they took over the Moabites. To them, they have conquered, they've spoiled everything they had, and it was victory for them. But this one who has no knowledge about what to do, he look at himself, will I allow this battle to overtake me? Will I allow myself go to this dimension? And what do I do? The scripture said he took his first son that was to be in his stead. And what does that mean? His son that was to be in his position. The son that was to bear his name and slaughtered it. And when God saw it and God said, how can? Why would this be? And that provoked God. Now, the authority that sent them, the authority back out. The authority that sent the people back out. Because somebody came with an holy anger and said, this is the way out. And that was how they lost the battle. It doesn't mean that God was not behind them. A blood was initiated. And that is why, hear me, child of God, any blood has been initiated in your family where you are coming from that is making life difficult, that is making what you are going through to look as if the enemy is so powerful, that makes your prayer look like the prayers of the 50s of Baal, that Elijah have to tell them, maybe your God went to public holiday, or your God is not around, he went at the back, call him until that God comes. And the Bible said the call and nothing was coming. Many of you, your prayer has become a burden. You have prayed, you have fasted, you have cried, and look as if God traveled. not because God is wicked. Sometimes when there is a blood speaking on the post, he becomes a judgment. He becomes a destruction. And so the enemy has it as a platform to fight to destroy you. But hear me, grace is coming. Anywhere the enemy has programmed blood in order to take your blood or take your property or take your children, the power in the blood of Jesus that speaks better things will come as an atonement to speak rescue upon your family, to speak rescue upon your destiny, to speak rescue upon your glory. If I'm hearing, can I hear the amen louder? It takes the blood. It takes blood to subdue blood. It takes blood to subdue blood. If you go to the book of Exodus chapter 12, Exodus chapter 12, the Bible was talking about the 24 and 25, that on that night, God was to carry out vengeance in Israel, in Egypt. And what did God do when he has a vengeance to carry? The Bible said, God said to them, take up the blood of the sacrifice. Take up the blood of the rams and goats and whatever, and sprinkle it upon the doors. And I will pass this night. And upon who that doesn't have it, that person become a casualty and a prayer. And that was how they did in Exodus chapter 12, verse 25. The Bible said they took up the blood upon every doorpost. And that was a Passover of old. And Jesus became the new present Passover in our new episode. And the scripture said they took up that blood. And soon as the blood was on the post, on that night God came and said, tonight is a night of destruction. I want to visit Egypt, and whoever is not of me, I will use this as a sign to know that they are not part of me. Tonight, this morning, I am praying for somebody. Any blood that have been shed in your family that has brought destruction, the blood of Jesus as a Passover blood is here to speak, to deliver, to redeem you, and to rescue you. Whatever the enemy has made that gave them the impetus to swallow your destiny and swallow your glory, the speaking blood of Jesus is here. And by the decree of the blood, every covenant fighting your life, fighting your destiny, the blood of Jesus will come and rescue you out. The blood of Jesus will come and liberate you out. I don't know who I'm talking, ready to receive this deliverance. If you are that person, shout out amen, louder like thunder. You know why God has respect upon Abel and not Cain? Cain took of the proceeds from the farm. But Abel took of the lamb that he has slaughtered and gave to God. And when God saw it, he said, no, what I have seen. It shows the kind of heart you have. God is not as if God hate the one that from the farm proceed, but God saw the blood that this man, you have done what I couldn't believe. And the same thing happened in the days of Adam and Eve. And how did it happen? When they lost the glory from the Adam, from the Garden of Eden, they took up a skin cloth into them, an animal cloth. In other words, if you want to go details, they would have killed an animal, and that was how they had the access to put it on. And because of that, God was speaking to say to somebody hearing me, whatever the enemy has used as an exchange to cover your foundational glory that God gave to your family from the day your family was born, the blood that has grace is here today. That is the blood of Jesus. You don't need the blood of rams. You don't need the blood of goats. You don't need the blood of animal. You don't need the blood of man. All you need is the blood of Jesus. And that's why the Bible said they overcame by the blood of the Lamb. And that speaking blood of Jesus is coming as a redemption. It's coming as a deliverer. It's coming to set somebody free today. If you are that person, let your amen show it louder like thunder. In those days, we were told that the early 70s, 70, 80 somethings, that when some missionaries came into town and they came to certain communities, and when they came, our forefathers saw the way they look and said, these people are too fearful for us. If we give them the room, they may take certain things from us. And so we need to close the chapter. And they did everything to stop them. The missionary were still rugged and said, we are not going anywhere. And when they saw her, they were, they said, okay, for we to be sure of your assignment, we need to involve into blood covenant. And that was what they did at the days of their ignorance. And the scripture said they took of their blood, and from the experience of the episode, they took of their blood and put my wine and they drank it. And you know what it means when somebody to be a deadly blood covenant? What affects that person affects you? What destroyed that person destroy you? Thank God for the blood of Jesus. When the blood of Jesus was given to us, what affects him as to progress, as to good health, as to restoration, became the byproduct of what we are carrying. So whatever he died for, that he said, I have given to you, becomes what we are enjoying. Those times our fathers saw
suffer those things as a result of ignorance. And many today are under the impediment of what they cause. But for us here, we are finding favor because Jesus gave it all free. And today, somebody hear me, the blood that has never speaking grace on you, the battle that look as if is stronger than your efforts, the blood is coming to overtake for you. The demon that have been resisting your prayers, resisting your fasting, resisting the anointing in this altar, by the speaking blood of Jesus, they will bow. I thought somebody was ready to receive. By the speaking blood of Jesus, they will bow. By the authority in the blood of Jesus, I said they will bow. And listen, anywhere you find a blood covenant, there's a name attached. When you find out the evil names of those times, once you call the name, it is not only that person, an entity is attached. The physical person and the spiritual person. And that is why in the scripture, when God told Abraham to take up the ram and the lamb and do a sacrifice, it was in the same time that the same blood of Jesus became our atonement. And from that time, their names changes. That from there, they're no longer bearing the names people used to bear. The name they started bearing changes. For example, some people started bearing Elijah. And what does Elijah mean? From God. It means Elijah. Represent God. Elisha talking about salvation. Samuel made this one is the one I asked and God gave it to me. Abimelech name was somebody you call this God is my king. And if you check the name, all those are names of God. Elohim, Elohim, these are names of God. You know, so they were calling the names. And so when they had these names attached, when you call the name of this kind of these people, you are not only calling the name, you are calling the entity that belongs to the name. So when you call their name, Elijah, you are calling God of that. And so grace come and follow the name. That is why you see that some people's name are fighting them, not because of sin, they are not born again, they are not spiritual. The names they are bearing have some evil negative attachment. So when you call them, the entity attached to this name work for them. He fights and disgrace and bring shame. And they keep wondering, why should that continue bearing this name? There was a time we had a name here. Somebody shared, he said, my name is Okpetubieso. What is the meaning of that? It means wahala is too difficult to overcome. So it means every time of your life, wahala should be coming. But hear me, child of God, if you carry such a negative and influential and a possessed and demonic name and a spell name that could bring destruction, grace is coming upon you. That yoke shall be broken. That demon, that spell shall be broken. And that's why I'm praying for somebody hearing me today. Every stronghold attached to your name that is fighting your personality, that is fighting the kind of person you should have been in life, and they doesn't want it to come to pass, that yoke is broken. That amen does not look like you. I said that yoke is broken. I said that yoke is broken. What is the name of Joshua? Jehoshua, from the Greek word. That means a name that represents Jesus in the New Testament. That is the meaning. So if you call people like that, it's not only their name. Something is attached. A covenant is attached, a force is attached, a power is attached. There's something that followed them because of the covenant attached. But many of us, the kind of name we bear, a name that does not give glory to God. And that was why when I was born again, the first thing God did was to give me a contention. You must change your name. It was a battle. I said, no, my family is too big for me to change the name. It's a big, royal big note. When no family, he said, that is not what I'm interested. I want to give you a name that is bigger than your family. Hear me, when God call you, separate you from your family. He gives you a name bigger than your family. When God called Abraham, he said, leave your father's house. He changed his name from being a bracket and established and give him a name bigger than him. Today, every covenant that has been attached to the name you bear by blood, by the reason of the speaking blood of Jesus, that yoke shall be broken today. That spell is broken today. That divination is broken today. That curse is broken. I don't know who is receiving it. Let me hear the amen loudest. Somebody said, I'm coming out. Somebody said, I'm coming out. Say it again, I'm coming out. And when there are blood covenants, there are three major factors that is involved. Number one factors, the parties involved. The parties, number one. Number two factors, the promise of the blood covenant involved. One, the parties to the promise of the blood covenant. Thirdly, the condition of the covenant. So this is not just an ordinary thing, you see. The condition. In the days we are, God, Jesus' blood came to give us an assurance. The blood was shed for our liberation. The blood came to give us not only assurance, sound health, provision, supernatural deliverance. And that's what we are finding today. I told you three things that were crucial that the blood came out from. But time was not enough to explain them much. That's last Sunday. But this Sunday, I want to go back to seven analog drops from various scriptures that Jesus shed his blood. Seven analog. One of them is in Isaiah 50 verses. Isaiah chapter 50 and verses. Isaiah chapter 50 verses. Number one, he said, Isaiah 56 said, I gave my back to the smiters and my cheeks to them that plug off the hair. I hide not my face from shame and spitting. If you read verse 7 of it, he said, I gave my back. He said, for the Lord God will help me, therefore shall I not be confounded. Therefore have I set my face like a flint, and I know that I shall not be ashamed. In that verses, he said, they pluck his beard. That was saying, I gave my back to the smiters and my cheeks to them. And what did they do? They plug off my hair. So one of the place blood came from was from his beard. They plug off my hair. I hide not my face from shame and spitting. Number two, where the blood came out from. And you need to follow me very fast. Luke 22, 44. The Bible said he sweated. And the sweat that came out of him was like a drip of blood. He sweated. And the sweat, Luke 22, 44. And the sweat that came out of him. And being in an agony, he prayed more earnestly. And his sweat was as a great drop of blood falling down in the ground. Number three, where the blood came from. Matthew 27 verse 29. We had this read on Sunday. He said, they put a crown of thorns. They put a crown of thorns upon my head. And that dropped blood from him. And when they had plaited the crown of thorns, they put it upon his head and a reed in his right hand. And they bowed down the knee before him and mocked him and saying, hey, King of Jews. They put it upon him. And that was what I told you. I said, some of you here, you are carrying a head, but since your head is under mockery, you are carrying a head, since the enemy is telling you nothing is good coming out of this head. You are carrying a head, and they don't want that head. People mock your head, but grace is upon you. Jesus received that mockery so that your head will be delivered. Jesus received that open shame and spitting and spiting and all the kind of things that were done to him so that anything that stands as a shame and disgrace will be redeemed from you. And so by the encounter in the power in the blood of Jesus, whatever the enemy has done to bury and bring shame and disgrace, whatever they have done to conclude your destiny, grace is coming in the name of Jesus. If you are that person, let your amen show it. That same Matthew 27 verse 26, number 4. Where blood came out of him and the blood were drawn to speak for your life. He said, then release he Barabbas unto them. And when he had scourged Jesus, he delivered him to be crucified. They scourged him. They laid stripe upon him. Scourged him with his stripe. Blood came out. Every stripe carried their deliverance. As they were giving him beer. HIV, get out. Diabetes, get out. Poverty, get out. Sickness, get out. Untimely death, get out. By the time they completed the seventh stripe upon him, then he said, I have received it not because of me, but because of you. So for you to hear me, child of God, whatever blood sacrifice that has been made in your forefathers, in your present generation, that is walking or speaking, or there is an occultic background that is saying you cannot grow beyond your level, we have exchanged your family, we have exchanged your foundation. By the measures of this blood, that covenant is broken. That power fighting you is delivered. I command your freedom. If you are that person, let your amen show it. Psalm 22 verse 16. Number 5. The Bible said they pierce his hand and blood gush out. They pierce his hands and blood goes out. For dogs have compassed me. The assembly of the wicked have enclosed me. They pierce my hands. Kalaba Shandaya. They pierce my hand. They pierce his hand. And I said to you on Sunday that many of you labor, you don't see the proof of your labor. Many of you struggle to gather things, but yet your hands look empty and look dried. Where others are succeeding, your hands goes there, nothing is working. Because a blood covenant is speaking against you. But hear me, because the Bible said they pierced his hand and blood came out. Where did the blood came out? To show to them that you are his candidate. To show to them that you have been redeemed by the blood. To show to them that you have been set at liberty by the blood. And everything that tried to oppose or challenge your rights by this encounter, receiving this blood of Jesus that was cut out of his hand, any power that said you will walk and not gather, that power is cursed. That amen does not look like this person. I said that power is cursed. The demons and forces that make sure you gather, you walk, and yet they come to take them from you. Hear me, child of God, that your hand will gather from today. Whatever you labor, your hands will gather it. Whatever you have struggled, you have suffered for, and they say you will not inherit it, your hands will inherit it. If you are receiving it, shout out amen. In that same scripture, Psalm 22 verse 16, if you read further, the Bible says blood gush out of his feet. And what does that mean? You know that to outline and direct your step. Many of us, our steps are not ordered by God. Our steps are not directed by God. And once your steps are not directed, enemies take advantage. It said, for dogs have compassed me. Dogs have compassed me. The assembly of the wicked have enclosed me. They pierced my hands. And they went further. What did they do? It pierces my feet. So anywhere your feet have been, that you cannot live a fulfilled life, your leg will not get to where others are getting to, your destiny will not become what the Lord has destined for you. Hear me, child of God, that demonic plantation against you, that evil power that has stopped your leg where you are, you are moving but you are not doing anything, nothing to show. In the book of Mark, where I read for you, Mark 11, the scripture said that the coat was tied. Why was the coat tied? Because the doesn't want the greatness. The authority that tied him, a higher authority came and said, you, this cord that I've been tied here, I untied you. Get loose. And from that day, the authority that tied him could no longer understand it. They could no longer hold it. Why? Because the authority of Jesus was higher than them. The authority of Jesus superseded the authority. And so they could not hold the feet of the coat down. I said, anywhere the rope or the radial is, that is what determines where the coat goes. Many of you are moving around, but nothing is moving to your leg. You move from ministry to places. You submit proposals and documents. You submit so many things, yet nothing is coming forth because of the hands and the leg that are tied. But child of God, hear me, today is a day of grace. We are in the month of forceful breakthrough. And what does it bring? What does it mean to be forceful? It means to be aggressive. And what was the commissioner grace that brought the forcefulness? It was the blood of Jesus that came and took us back to the Garden of Eden. We don't need to build an Eden garden where we stay, but inside of you, when you receive Christ, the Eden life comes to you, the life of peace, the life of joy in the Holy Ghost. And I'm here to prophesy, somebody here, any power that have tied down your leg, tied down your hands, that you cannot make it in life, you cannot become great, what God has destined for you, you cannot achieve it. By hearing this prophecy this morning, everywhere the enemy has locked your hand and your leg, every spirit of death has sent to conclude on you, by the blood of Jesus, you shall be redeemed. By the blood of the Holy Ghost, you shall be set free. By the blood of Jesus, you are redeemed. By the blood of the Holy Ghost, you shall be set free. If you are receiving it, shout out amen. And number 7, in John 19:34, the Bible said they pierced his side and blood came out. They pierced his side and blood came out. And when they pierced, John 19:34, but one of the soldiers with a spear pierced his side. Yala baba. They pierced his side, and the Bible said, with forthwith came there out blood and water. When they pierced it, it said it came forth blood and water. So Jesus' blood was the blood of the second episode that changed the one that the forefathers and grand, or whatever you call them, have put in place, that are speaking judgment and destruction, that have empowered the serpents, that have empowered demons, that have empowered the evil forces to be over your life. Because why?
the blood speaketh better things than the blood of Abel. And that is the blood of Jesus that is coming to redeem you. Anytime the blood is measured, Satan is afraid. Because Satan knows that was the receipt that shook him out of the place. The Bible said, be lifted up, O you gate, everlasting door, that the King of glory, the Lord strong, mighty in battle. And Satan said, who is the Lord strong? I am a man of battle. Who is the Lord mighty in battle? And Jesus said, the Lord strong, mighty. He said, I am one of them. And he went further and said, I am a king in different area. I have sheep, I have subjects under me. Who are you talking about? And Jesus said, the Lord of hosts. This is my receipt. You can't hold this one. This is my receipt. You can't hold this one. The blood was shed. You said that you know you cannot shed blood. And that is why Jesus sitting on the right hand of the Father, interceding for you and I, that anytime you pray, every time he declare and he decree, he said, my Father, not according but according to your will, not by mine but according to your will. And I told you some months or years ago, I said, what is a will? A will is something that's been written down by a testator, and not until the person die, a will cannot be enforced, a will cannot be carried out. If a man have written his will and is still alive, you can't go to the court and declare that property as his own. You can't go to the court and say that property belongs to you. The man who wrote the will need to go before you enforce it. And that's why Jesus died and went to the cross of Calvary, interceding in the right hand of the Father, that anytime you pray, there might be grace and mercy. Anytime you decree upon the name of Jesus, enemy knows that that is the receipt for you to overtake. And from that day, he sat on the top and never came down. That he was taken up by the scribes and the Pharisees, by the soldiers, he never came down. Fred, from that time, if you ask him according to his will, the Bible said, he heareth us. Why? A price has been paid. Today, that price is coming. No wonder in 1 Corinthians chapter 16, 20 say, for we are bought with a price. A price has been redeemed. A price has been given to you. A price has been given to us. That is the grace and the power that we have. That when we call the blood of Jesus, Satan goes back, because he never shed his blood. He has never made any attempt one day for his blood to be shed. His only mission is to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But the blood that was shed is a gateway for your deliverance. It's a gateway to recover. It's a gateway to find your breakthrough. It's a gateway for you to find your peace. I decree and I declare, as you enforce your will before God today, anything that has been given to you by God, that destiny will come to pass. That destiny will come to pass. If I'm talking to you, can I hear the amen? When Jesus died, he said, if I don't go up, if I allowed Nigeria judges or judges from other countries to stay there, they can bribe them. So let me be the judge. Let me be the senior advocate to represent you. So anytime you call me according to his will, I will declare. You need healing? Take. Fruitfulness? Take. Prosperity? Take. All these ones you need, I die for them. Take, take, take. From today, you are taking them back. I say from today, you are taking them back. Whatever enemy taken from you or collected from you, grace is coming by the blood of Jesus. You will recover everything back. I said you will take everything back. If I'm hearing you, can I hear the amen? So before Jesus came, the enemy have used blood severally to manipulate people's star, people's destiny. Even to date, we know a lot of people use blood to make money and do all kind of things. But at the end of it, it is destruction. So if you wash your life and sit on the fence, the enemy will keep you on that ground. But when you stand them and say, whatever you have collected for me, I stage a war of the blood. Whatever glory, whatever destiny I carry that they have exchanged in the covenant of darkness, let the blood restore it. The moment you take that to work, the blood start coming, the grace start coming. And I pray, as we go by the blood of Jesus today, whatever they have been taking from you secretly, openly, they will recover them. The blood of Jesus was the host that came, that the stronghold of darkness that have been in the gate could not stand. And that's why when he said be lifted up, at the final decision of it, Satan could not stand it. Those who were buried according to the scripture then, as of then, who have not made heaven, all of them find themselves, the Jacob, the Abraham, everybody have an entrance when the blood came. The blood is a gateway for you to find where you can recover from. He takes you beyond your strength. He takes you beyond your ability. He takes you beyond what you least expected. And that's why, as the Lord has said, this morning is a forceful breakthrough. Whatever enemy said is not possible, with the blood you will take them back. If that amen looked like you, should have been better. With the blood you will take them back.
If I'm hearing, can I hear the amen? Finally, what did the blood of Jesus brought for us? The scripture said in Revelation chapter 5 verse 9. Revelation chapter 5 verse 9. Revelation 5 verse 9. What did the blood brought for you and I? And the Bible say, and they sang a new song. Revelation chapter 9, 11 and 12. And they sang a new song, saying, thou art worthy to take the book. The blood brought a book for you and I. To take the book and to open the seal thereof. Somebody say the seal. This morning we shall be going to the covenant, seven seal of the covenant. And to open the seal thereof. For thou was slain and has redeemed us. Redeem us to God. By what? By what? By blood out of every kindred and tongue and people and nation. So nobody was exempted. This was a covenant platform that gave us the victory. Verse 11. What did he say in Revelation 12? We read 9 now. And verse 11 and verse 12. What did he say? And I beheld and I heard the voice of many angels round about the throne and beast and the elders. And the numbers of them was 10,000 times 10,000 and thousands of thousands. Verse 12. What did he say? Saying with a loud voice, what is the lamb that was slain to receive power? Makusalia. I fear somebody's getting it now. To receive what? What follow number two? What follow number three? What follow number three? What do you know? What's the next one? And what's the other one? And glory and what? Somebody said, I need my blessing. So what did the covenant platform the blood gave to us? Number one, he brought to us power. But do you know Jesus never needed power? He came to give you and I the power. And that's why the Bible said, I have given you power to tread upon serpents and upon everything that hurts you. And by the mention of the name of Jesus, every name shall do what? I'm not hearing. So shall do what? So one thing the blood came to give to you is what? I didn't hear. What? And that's why when you pray, God hear you. When you call upon him the day of trouble, he answered you. He came to give you power. So if you don't know today, know it. That is why fear must die from you. Anytime Satan wants to attack a man, he brings fear. He brings intimidation. He makes you look as if you are a failure. He makes you look as if you can't make it. But once you are that person who has an audacious and temerity and pugnacious heart, your heart that does not fear, a ruggedious heart, Satan knows this one is not my candidate. That is why your heart must develop. What those little things, little demons and power that comes to intimidate you, wake up and intimidate them. Wake up and do what? Because he came to give you power. Number one, somebody say power. Number two, what did he come to give us there? What? Riches. He said, for because of you and I was poor. So that you become what? So he came to give you riches. And that's why we call upon him. We see the things. Here we have seen people from credited 1. Something million, 1. This million. People who were nothing, who were downtrodden. People that, how do I describe it? They were looking onto people. Suddenly the thing turned. He gave them riches. Somebody hear me. That wealth you need. That grace you need. Those of you who said this ministry must be on here. That wealth you need to turn this ministry to another dimension, which is one of the covenant platform to raise financial pillars that will take the ministry abroad. I pray the grace of that wealth, receive it now. That amen does not look like you. I said receive it. And that's why Satan is a counterfeit of every original. He knows that there is wealth in God. He knows that there is power in God. That's why we have people on the other side. They try to show power. In the days of Moses, they tried to show power. In the days of wealth, talking about wealth, you see people tell you, I can turn this, I can turn that. Somebody will be a child of God and enter a vehicle and say, the driver said, I saw so money. And this money now, how do we do it? It's one allergy. Let us go and wash it. Let us go and do this. And the child of God will really follow because he need that kind of money. Is that allergy your father? You miss it. So when someone I dupe you, they didn't dupe you, they have not started. Your mind has not been made on him. If your mind is made on him, carry that your money you have with Elijah, go and give it to the Elijah. Is that not true? If I say raise up your hand, they have duped you once. Many of you will raise up your hand. You were born again, no, but they dupe you. You are not supposed to be duped because there is an authority inside of you. Number three, what did he say he came to give to us? Because we are going to prayer now. What did he say he came to give to us?
wisdom. And what did he say in Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 10? He said what? Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 10. What did he say? We have been preaching on wisdom for quite almost about series now. Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 10. He said if they what? If the iron be blunt and do not whet the edge, then must it be put to what? It doesn't need strength. What did he say need? Somebody say, what did he say need? Wisdom. In Proverbs 8, he talk about wisdom. That wisdom, quiet and understanding add his voice. In Proverbs chapter 1 verse 1, my son, listen, wisdom. Proverbs 2, 1, my son, wisdom. Proverbs 3, my son, wisdom. Proverbs 4, 1, he cried, wisdom has been on the street. Proverbs 5, 1, my son, wisdom. 6, my son, 8, 7, 8. He said, I cry. So what is it, what he came to give to us? Wisdom. It was wisdom he gave the children of Israel to pass the Red Sea without building bridge. If they have taken that time to build bridge, the enemy would have conquered them. But it was wisdom he gave them. Without building bridge, God gave them wisdom to pass. So there are certain battles some of you are fighting you are not supposed to fight. If wisdom is in place, you didn't hear me. You didn't hear me. There are certain battles you are fighting now. You don't need to fight them. If wisdom is in place, he gave them wisdom. What number four? What did he say he gave to us? Strength. He said, take my strength. Strength. For by my strength you are made whole. He came to give you strength. Strength to the weak. Strength to the feeble. Strength for that one that is weakling. So you don't need to look like what you are. And that's the strength you carry. He came to give you and I strength. Somebody say strength. That strength you need. Some of you are just 50 years. You look as if you want to die tomorrow. You need strength. Somebody say, I need strength. Say it again, I need strength. From today, the strength you need to fulfill your age, your days on earth, receive that strength. That amen doesn't look like you. Receive that strength. Receive that strength. What is the last one he came to give to us? He came to give us glory. Someone say glory. That is what he came to give to you and I. By putting his value inside us. By making us a man and woman of importance. He came to give us glory. Many of you today would have not been where you are if not for the Holy Spirit. Two of us. Somebody like me now would have not been where I am if not for God. When that pastor shared the testimony of that horse, he took me back when I had a encounter in Israel. The first time I went to Israel, we got to one of the mountains or so, the mountain of Mount Tabor or so. It was a great encounter. I never forget it. One of the mountains. See, people go to Israel, but God gave me one grace and one understanding. Those churches, they are just old sepulchre you go to. But there is a place I found in Israel. My father. You don't go there and come back without receiving a virtue. Yeah. When he mentioned white horse, he took me back. Who am I? He came to, the blood came to give you 7 seal. After today, if you don't know your identity in Christ, the 7 book, the book that will open, not knowing what you carry, after this service, you will discover your blessing. You will discover your destiny. That's why as a child of God, you don't need to mess up. You don't need to be messing around. Because if you mess around, that horse will change. You'll be using leg to trek. That horse will go away. You will struggle. Look at the testimony of the man of God. He said the horse was swallowing the snake. When you heard the testimony of this woman, that 21 years under torment, there's no churches in Warri she has not attended. And just yesterday here, very big boa. To those who are not inside, who know what she's saying, they would think she's just talking. But when you have entered inside bondage once, and what did I came to address yesterday, bondage? Very short. And I told them, after this, it is over. Every bondage that has been attached, despite the name of Jesus, you still see the bondage so strong in your life, in your family. The grace in that blood will deliver you from that bondage.
You didn't hear me. I said the grace will deliver you from that bondage. What is the next one? Honor. Is it not honor? He said one, honor, glory, and the final one, what?
From today, the blessing that I've been looking, you have been looking for, they will be the one look for you.
There is blessing, sir. These are the seven seeds the blood came to give to you and I. Know it. Take your time to study the place. These are the seven seals. So when you find out that what is the essence of serving God, what are the benefits? Look at the benefits. The seven seal that he said, not even an angel that was worthy, not even any man that was worthy. It was the blood. And that's any time the blood is mentioned, you repeat the episode of Calvary. You bring it back to life. And you look around. Who are those that have been oppressed? Who are those that have been cheated? Who are those that the enemy has taken destiny and glory from? Let me use the blood that I used at that time. And they start playing the blood to look at the person that Satan has taken destiny on, enemy about to finish. And they say, take by the reason and by the encounter of this. And that's why today's service, what prayer you're going to pray is almost similar. Anything that used blood, enemy have used blood to collect from me by witchcraft, today, by the blood of Jesus, I take it back. I take my honor, I take my glory, I take my blessing, I take my strength, I take back my wisdom, I take back my understanding. Whatever has been taken from me, you will recover them. You didn't hear me. I say you will recover them. I say you will recover them. Let me hear that amen louder like thunder.
Stand up on your feet. We want to go into the prayer. The blood. The Bible said it speaketh better things by the than the blood of what? In Revelation 12 verse 11, it says you overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of your testimony. And it said that you love yourself not unto death. It went further. In verse 17 or so, the Bible said, for the earth opened up its mouth and helped the woman and swallowed the flood that was sent by Satan. So there is a flood, enemy flood. And I told you, I said, there are certain dreams you dream, you don't take them for granted. Many of us will become too familiar. They can't do you anything. Yes, it is. But know the level of your weapon before you take something for granted. The earth opened their mouth. And what the earth did, he said, they helped the woman. And that's why we're going to speak. Anything that have been done on this earth by blood exchange to take away your blood, let the blood of Jesus destroy. Let the blood of Jesus fight for me. Let the blood redeem me. The Bible says seven seas was open, not even a man and angel. It was the blood of Jesus that did it. I want you to lift your hands and you are going to shout 21 blood of Jesus. After the 21 blood of Jesus, every strange sickness, hotness, anything you don't like going through your life, oh, you are going to use the blood to speak against them. Before I start praying for you, lift your two hands and decree the blood 21 times. Raise it up and shout the blood 21 times. Let's go. Say it louder. Put more fire. Increase it as four. The fifth time. The sixth time. The five. The six times. The seven times. The eight times. The nine times. The 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Oh, yeah, ask the blood to destroy anything that is not of God in your life, in your family, in your destiny. Open your mouth and ask the blood. Plead the blood against them. Satan does not have that blood. It is only in Christ. Plead the blood. Plead the blood. Plead the blood.